minute, we will be live. I'd like to be able to count down like I used to in the olden days.
Yeah, with the peacock. And then they used to say in living color.
Oh, NBC. Yeah. Live from downtown Houston, it's the Ginger Crumb Monday Show, live with Ginger. Ginger, hey, Ginger, where are you? You must be out there somewhere.
Hey, John, I'm over here. Did you miss me? Hi,
you
guys.
Oh, there you are.
I think you got our co-producer, Sammy.
I'm telling you, he snuck in on you.
He did. Boy, Sammy just sneaks in there, doesn't he, you guys? So, hey, welcome to our Monday Cookie Crumb Show. This is sort of fun. Mondays we do focus in on something and try to show you something kind of unique in your painting skills that will benefit you and, you know, help you progress regardless of what else you're painting. And acrylic painting, there's so many different ways to paint acrylics. You know, this is just one way. That's what I always tell you. If there's 50 different ways to paint an ocean and I show you 10, for instance, as an example, the 11th way is going to be somehow your unique thing. So what you're going for is your unique handwriting, but you need to know the steps to get there. So that's what kind of we're doing, to help you become unique to you and kind of, you know, you get an idea, gosh, wouldn't this make a great painting? And I'd like someday to just think that, you know, if you have an idea for a great painting, you could just sit down and execute it. How cool would that be? Well, you know, you do that by learning techniques and focusing in on small things and saying, this is how I'd paint this or this is how I'd paint that. It's like a vocabulary. Think about a vocabulary. You just go to a foreign country, you learn a few words like food, restaurant, bathroom, train, you know, those kinds of things. And that's kind of where you are sometimes when you first start out as an artist. You learn leaf, flower, something, you know. And then you expand your vocabulary, and that's what we're going to be doing today, expanding our artistic vocabulary. John, if you would be so kind as to focus down on our canvas of what we're going to paint today. This was, we're building on what we learned last week. Remember last week we did, we talked about how to do these flower pots. How cool is that? And a lot of you really like that. We've had over 10,000 views on this one a picture alone. We're almost up to 11,000. This has been very popular. So now I'm going to show you how to take this idea and turn, and what else could you do with these flower pots? Well, we've got a red umbrella. It's raining. So I'm going to show you how to create some rain, how to create a few reflections. You want to zoom in on that for me, please?
Yes, ma'am. And remember, you can't talk to the camera because you're still on the camera.
I'm still on camera. So I'm sorry. I keep looking over at John because he's in the room. It seems weird to look at an inanimate object and talk to you. I mean, I'm just, it's really
I do that all the time. What's wrong with that?
I know, John. Okay. We know. It's okay. We know that, but there's some medication for that mostly, you know, but in this case, what we've got is I'm going to look here in the monitor now. You can see when you focus in on that, we've got these flower pots, not that different than these guys, right? But now we've got this umbrella and a background, and we're doing the 6x8, so we can just show you rather quickly. This is kind of fun. I'm going to show you, I'm using a Paramount, a real canvas tablet, but you could do this probably easily 8x10 too. And actually, this would be pretty large. You just have to, you know, make everything bigger. And I'm going to tear off one of these sheets. They're real canvas. It's gesso canvas. Jerry sells them.
Oh, wait a minute. I have to interrupt you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Ginger. My mom got her painting today and was extremely touched.
The angel paintings came through.
Yeah.
We sent out the angel paintings. And in fact, John, if you think about it, you might want to show Sharon with her angel painting.
Oh, let's talk about that now that we're live. Okay, yeah, we can do that.
Yeah, well, I just thought of it now, right?
But, oh, well.
All good. Right. Sharon got hers and sent us a picture of it, so we're so glad your mom got hers. We, you know, we had a thing where we did these angels, and I painted some angels, and we actually have one as a lesson for our gingercooklive.gallery, if you happen to have a picture of that somewhere. We sent the angels off, so you'd have to
have
it on your computer.
I'll have it when I bring Sharon's picture up.
John will find a picture later. So anyway, the deal was, we said, if you know, we asked people to... I'll tell you the story as we go, because I'm getting sidetracked here, all right? So I want to say that the person in the background that you're listening to, John Little, is our executive producer. He's the other partner in gingercooklive.gallery. He's the guy that's running all the cameras. There's four cameras going tonight. We have got a show for you. This will be fun. We're going to learn how to paint all this stuff. I'm going to show you how to do it. We got Sammy as you know, our extra helper. And I'm basically, don't worry about painting along with me. I would just say follow along with what I'm doing. You can if you want, but you might miss something, and we're going to leave this up. We're not taking it down. There's a nice group of people here. We've got the our live artists on YouTube, you know, that we those of us that are doing live shows on YouTube, we have attracted, I think, some of the nicest people on the planet that come play with us. And that's you guys. And you can look at some of those other venues, you know, those gamers and some of those other people on YouTube that do live shows. And they don't have the experience this group does. That you, I'm telling you what, you have a unique experience. Get to know some of your friends from around the planet. And, you know, because there's people from all over the world tuning in watching this. Now, we're going to have a titanium white, thalo, dazzling purple, ultramarine blue. I am using today a new blue that for some of you, if you're a water painter, like oceans, you might know about this, Southern Ocean Blue. If you don't have this, just use thalo, okay? But I'm using Southern Ocean Blue, yellow, and that's a Matisse color from Australia, but yellow oxide, and this is a Naples yellow, cad yellow medium. Don't worry, if you don't have Naples yellow, you're just gonna add a little white to cad yellow medium. Burnt umber, magenta, naphtha crimson, and cad red medium. And someone's going to say, is that quadrichrome magenta? Yeah, it is. And basically, flowers are kind of the things where you can do right out of the tube. So whatever you got handy, use those. Doesn't it? I mean, if you've ever been to somebody's flower garden, you know, lots of different colors of flowers. So it doesn't have to be exactly my colors, you know, just as a suggestion about what we're doing. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make this gray, and we're going to paint the background in. And while we're doing that, then I can tell you some stuff here. So, again, now this background, I want you to say it. Every color wheel has a grayscale. See that? Every color. So there's my grayscale here. That's the light side of the grayscale. You can zoom in on that for me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. That's the light side of the grayscale right here. See that white and then all these light grays. And then this is the dark side of the grayscale, all right? So if you're, this color here, if this were black and white, it's probably in between these two. It's really closer to the light side. So here's the rule for mixing paint. If you were to turn your color into a black and white picture, you know, the color you're trying to make, and the gray is on this side of the grayscale, the dark side, you start with the darkest color first to mix it, all right? And if it's on the light side of the grayscale, it's going to be 98% white or yellow, pretty much those two colors. Most of the time, it'll be 98% white, all right? Now, if you understand that, you'll waste a lot less paint. I mean, that is just such a cool thing to know. And what we're going to do is we're going to start with a palette knife somewhere. Oh, I just lost my...
Oh, they're asking about that box.
Yeah.
They go, what's that Amazon box? Well, it's not an Amazon this time, guys.
Where'd the box go? How are they seeing the box?
It's on the side.
Where is it?
It's on the floor now. I'll have to get it in a second.
Oh, it just fell on the floor. we're going to open that in a minute. All right. And also, I want to... so we'll talk about that. I didn't want this big palette knife. Where's the small ones? What is going
Studio
on?
Studio A? Did you take it to A?
I don't know. Well, crumb. All right. I know there's some behind the sink. I have one behind the sink. There's
gotcha.
One behind the sink. This is too big for this little space. All right. We're starting with white. Titanium white. Okay. Now, let's add a tiny bit of Southern Ocean Blue. Like that. That's your sort of turquoisey blue. Isn't that pretty? Now, if you didn't have that, you can add thalo. See, look, much better. Smaller knives. Yeah, okay. Here we go. I love these. Thank you. All right. So here's this little one right here. Now, I'm going to a little ultramarine blue. Put a little ultramarine blue in there. Maybe a little more of that. Then you'll see me scraping and squishing. And then a little tiny bit of cad red medium. And that's going to gray it. This is going to gray. The cad red medium is what grays the color. Now, this is going to be kind of a blue-gray color for the background. Yeah, a little more Southern Ocean Blue, a little more cad red medium, a little more white. Going to probably use all that white. Here, let's just make a nice grouping of color. And you have to kind of squish it and pull it and then mound it back up. Now, the thing about something like rain, and let's put a little Southern Ocean Blue in that. And again, that could be thalo too for you. And even a touch of yellow would have worked. The thing about that, maybe let's do a little tiny bit of burnt umber. I'll show you what happens when you do that. That we're graying this out. Okay, now thinking about what we're trying to create is rain. So you don't have to mix it so much. You see, you can have some streaks in it. That's all right. So now I'm going to just, this is a ruby satin silver number 8 bright brush. And I'm going to rinse it, wet it, wipe it off on a rag. And then I'm going to just get some of this paint here. And I want to go down with the paint. See that? The brush strokes are going down. Your brush strokes are like a groove in the record player. And which is kind of cool. And what you do is you just start pulling the paint down. If you find something, nothing's happening, this canvas is a little rougher than the linen that we were painting on last week. So it's going to be in, and we don't sand the stuff that comes in the tablet. So you're going to have to put this on possibly a little thicker. It's all right. Then we're pulling it down. Now I'm out of paint. Now that's it. Now scrape up some more and keep going. So sometimes people just don't understand how much paint it takes to cover this. If you were putting peanut butter on toast, you'd have no problem knowing how much peanut butter needed to go on the toast, right? Or jam. So kind of think of it on those terms, all right? Our honey is supposed to say thin butter, all right? So, all right, now we're going to go this way across, and I'm going to wet my brush, wipe it off on the rag, okay? And I'm going to go across. I want a slightly damp brush. And then I'm going to go back and forth this way because this is kind of where our ground is. Get a little more of this paint. Now, the other reason your paint is drying out very quickly is that when you mix a color, you should make a point of bounding it back up. If you leave it real thin like that, it'll dry up in seconds. But you got to kind of pile it back up once if you've got any left over. All right, so there's our... All right, so that's our table, kind of our street, and here's the rain coming this way. You're going, I don't see any rain, Ginger. Yeah, that's okay. Well, I don't see any either, but that's you get. This is kind of how we're doing it. Now, that's about how far up? That would require a ruler, wouldn't it? Ah, here's one. Lucky us. Lucky us.
Oh, I dodged a bullet on that one.
Just lucky us. All right.
Well, we got in trouble there.
Now, listen, I'm having cataract surgery on Monday, so we're assuming I can read this ruler, but 3 inches about is what we did here. All right, now I'm going to take a little bit of the zinc white. I want to come up here into my sky and start down from the top here, and I want to pull some streaks of this, while it's still wet, of the zinc. Now, zinc or mixing white, either one would work. That's your translucent white. You can see through it. It's like cellophane, okay, as opposed to titanium, all right? And this really won't change the underneath color that much, but it will give that sort of feeling that you've got something coming down here. And I actually think I want to make a little darker gray. Just use my brush to do that. A little bit darker gray here, kind of. And then I want to come up here with a few of these darker green streaks, too, kind of in between those. There we go. Kind of this blue-gray green color. There we go. Kind of bring that down. Now you've got to start at the top and come down. So let's just keep, there you go. And I want a little bit of that. You see there? And I'm going to come across here at the bottom and bring some going across. Now don't forget your cad red medium. I'm not trying to get, this is sort of a blue-gray green here. Like that. Now, all right. Now we'll add some more later. Now we're doing the streaks, okay? So now we're doing the streaks and we're saying this is coming across this way. And we're going to start pulling some of this down a little further, kind of blurring out where our street starts and the rain is, okay? So that's about, this is what we've got here. Now take a little of the zinc white and just kind of do some wiggling business here like this. And you can see what I'm doing, just kind of wiggling back and forth, just like that, and creating sort of a splashy street. Ooh, like that, just like zigs, like rickrack, okay, zigzag it.
Since you mentioned your cataract surgery, they're afraid you're not going to be able to paint. Rest assured, she'll come back from surgery and she'll be painting probably Friday.
Well, yeah, but he said that, you know, I should be able to do a show Monday. I may have to wear sunglasses. It may be too bright to... to do a show on next Monday, but I will do, I'll just wear sunglasses.
That's, it should just be cool. She'll look cool.
I'll just look cool, like kind of the man from Uncle or something, you know, that kind of
deal. Don't worry about it. Don't worry, people. You'll have your ginger fix.
Yeah. All right. So there we go. So you see, this is what we've got so far. Already it looks a little puddly, doesn't it? We've got the rain coming down here like this. And it's a shame music is so copyrighted because I'd play rainy songs like, you know, Raindrops Are Falling on My Head or one of those songs or so
Butch
many
Cassidy
great.
The Sundance Kid.
Yeah, Butch Cassidy, Sundance Kid, so many great rain songs, aren't there? All right, so now you see we've got some rain going here, right? Just doing that. We'll add some more later. I guess I could put a little bit more streaks like this. There we go. Just something. Barely touching this. Like a kid that's sunburned, right? That's how try to make them go straight down. I guess you could have it all at an angle, too. Vanetta wrote me and said that she lives in Arizona. She says when it rains in Arizona, everything's going sideways. Oh, that's pretty dramatic for me. That's too much drama, you know, too much drama for this nice little painting with the flowers and the thing. So what I want to do now is put this brush in water, and I'm going to dry this. But listen, you want to know what I got?
I do.
All right. So this is...
Wait a minute. We're going to have to change the angle here. Let me zoom out a little bit.
Yeah.
That's zooming in.
There you go. All right. So this is...
Who's it from?
This is from the Brush Guys.
Now, this has not been opened. This is exactly how it comes.
This is exactly how it comes. John just did a knife here so I could open it easily for you, right? This is, if you order brushes from the Brush Guys, this is how they come. We thought we'd show you that. They didn't give me these. I mean, I bought them, okay? Now, all right, so I'm opening up the box.
Don't put it down on top of your painting.
Oh, yeah, good thought. We should
move
that.
You were just about to do that. I saw that.
All right. So here. So we're going to take the there's some newspaper. Let's see what it has to say here.
Where's it from? I always do that.
Oh yeah, where's it from? Let's see. This is the...
Remember, you do have glasses.
Good thought. This is the Orange County Register.
Ah, right there in Orange County, California.
And Samsung is blaming Note 7 batteries.
Oh, figures.
And
there's something being committed on the front.
What can you get there? You can get some windows and stuff. Well, this isn't helping you. So obviously the next. Just next. All right, now.
Ooh. New brushes. Now these happen to be?
Ruby Satin Silvers, which is, if these are my favorite all-time brushes, is what I use all the time. I bought a bunch of the little. I bought some angle ones, some half inch angle, some quarter inch angle, and some 3/8 inch angle, and look at that. And then I've got some little zero pointy ones, and then I have some bright ones. Let me just show you here. Box. Do we need? Oh, there's a note.
No, probably an invoice.
Oh, is that not a note? An invoice? How unfriendly is that? Is it an invoice?
It should be your packing slip. What'd you order?
All right, now this is what you do. This is perfect. Here, zoom, zoom, zoom. All right, so this is what you do when you order anything from an art store, you guys. You ready for this?
Pay attention, people.
I got my $5.89 discount because I put in my name, Ginger Cook, all one word. Then you get your discount. So $111 for these brushes, right? But I got a lot, right? So it says here how many I got of the different ones. And then you check them off. Don't wait till a week later and then call people up. This really happens when you order paint. When you're ordering paint from some of these online companies, so she'll be not be talked about, but you know who I'm talking about anyway, you know? rhymes with dick. I don't know.
Okay, this is a family show. Come on now.
Anyway.
Recovery.
I have found my personal thing is that there's usually something off in the order. And usually they're missing something. They sent two of the wrong thing or whatever. Because remember, people probably are packing this minimum wage, right? They're just packing your boxes, right? Somebody sent it down the pike. Who knows how it got in the box? Now, it's not like the personal hand care of the brush guys who do this themselves. So what you want to do, in any case, no matter where you get, I don't care what you're ordering, check it off on your invoice, because I have always found great customer service from everybody. If you call them up and say, hey, something wasn't in my box, gosh, they can't be hurry fast enough to get it to you. But if you wait 2 months, they're not going to believe you. So don't sit there, oh, these are my brushes or these are my paints. I'll just do this later. Here's my invoice. Here's my brushes. And I really, really like that. I got a filbert and some different ones, and see, we're kind of doing that. Let's see. Oh, they use Scotch tape. Boy, you know, the guy that invented Scotch tape should have a national holiday, too. We talk about all the people we think we should give holidays to, you know, awards, the Ginger Cook Award for great ideas, you know. And Scotch tape is one of them, isn't it? John and I, the air conditioning is like top on my list. That guy gets big hugs from me. Air conditioning. All right, so this is a number 12 Ruby Satin Long Silver Long Handle Bright Brush.
Look at
that. Isn't that nice? And then this is the companion filbert one with that.
That's going to be ready for some big paintings.
Yeah, some bigger paintings.
I'm thinking
do with
probably the
paintings.
Barn and the tractor.
Yeah. No, are you? Of course you were. Good to want things, John.
I heard you say
and,
yeah.
And then, so this, I love these because they have a fine chiseled edge, right? Here's an older one. Here's an older, this brush is, I don't know, maybe 15 years old. And you can see when they're new, they've got this nice fine chiseled edge. But this I still use all the time. All right, so there's kind of you can kind of see the difference. But they're wonderful brushes. But if all brushes wear out, you should replace them. And here's an older Ruby Satin Silver Bright brush that I've used for a long time. You see, it's a little bit wider here now. I don't get the fine chiseled edge as much as I would the new one. So you gotta replace these once in a while. All right, so. That being said, we've got some small ones which we can use, and I need to dry this. And listen, we have had, I want to just say it really quick, I want to show you another package. Angela Maxwell sent me this neat gift for my birthday, but I'm not going to open it till Wednesday, Angela. I'm going to open it Wednesday on the live show on Wednesday, just let you know we got it. Thank you very much. But I'll open it Wednesday. And also remember on our birthday, okay, remember on our birthday show, we've got,
what do we have?
We have a gift we're giving you guys.
What?
Yes, we're
Are
giving
you,
you guys a
You're
gift.
Still going through with that.
Yeah, and John has spent hours editing it. It's a wonderful video, and you're going to be able to own it completely. We can go to our website, and we'll have it. What are we going to call the tab when we have it?
I remember that. It's on my notepad somewhere.
He doesn't remember it. You do remember it?
Well, I kind of remember it.
You kind of anyway. We're gonna have a neat name for it. We'll let you know at some point, and then so you'll easily be able to find it.
Fan what? Birthday gift.
Fan birthday gift. What a great name, right?
It's so original.
It's the original name. We have a fan birthday gift, right? Here, let me just open all these brushes. Oh, I'm just in heaven now. Look at that. Oh, look at this.
We will get the lesson done tonight, though, right?
Yeah, this lesson's getting done tonight. You said to open these on the show. Now I'm just going. Sorry. Just toys, all right? So anyway, all right, I'm going to dry this. And John's got some great stuff to show you from some of our new guys that are doing great stuff.
Let's bring up... Sharon.
All right, I'm going to dry this, all right? So thanks, Sharon. And here it is.
There we go. There's Sharon.
Okay.
This is Sharon that won the angel, the big one. Great story, and she sent us a picture, was thrilled with it. I see my sister ask how many times I watched Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. Oh, I know it was about 15 times. Favorite movie of all time. All right, let's go on. Fox from Patty. This is the before. This is what...
We'll talk about personal art coaching, John, before you go.
This is, these are going to be some personal art coaching that Ginger does on the gingercooklive.com website. This is the first painting that Patty sent in, and Ginger had a few comments to make about it. And here are the comments. It looks like a pretty good painting to start with, right? And here are the back, here are the comments. What we've got is beautiful, great job on the background. Paint tail in different directions. Notice her tail is kind of split down the middle. So let's take a look at what she did. And the final from Patty, after the personal art coaching. There you go, take a look at the tail. And she made a few other choices. So let me go back between the two. I think Ginger's back, so we'll bring her back on.
Go ahead. That's good. You can put me in sand down. Yeah, show them that, because I think sometimes, you know, it's just a couple things, you know, that you just may not have noticed something. And brush direction is everything. We're talking about rain brush direction today, and brush direction is everything. So show the tail before and after. Sometimes that is a darling painting. The eyes on that fox are great, aren't they? And there's such an expression. And you guys, everybody that's painted that fox that we've had that's painted that, or members have painted that fox, everybody's got a slightly different expression on the face. And I don't know. It's just marvelous. I love this a lot. And didn't you do great? Did you switch back and forth between the two?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're seeing that effect now, even as we speak.
Oh, as we speak. See, that is so cool, because I can't see what he's seeing. I'm just looking in this monitor and just seeing something.
You can't see the monitor? What are you seeing on the monitor now?
Just the fox. Just the one fox.
Oh, well, they've been transposing. I suppose right. You want to come back to you
okay,
now, right?
So come back to me, and I'm going to show you something, all right?
Oh, the blackboard.
The blackboard's out, okay?
Class is in session, people.
Okay, so here's the blackboard. Now, all right, let's just get back to our picture, all right? Now, if you haven't done this one, that's on, you know, be sure you get to do this one, because that'll really explain how to do these flower pots easily. Now, we've got an umbrella. This, sometimes people get a little little stumped with this, but I'm going to show you the easiest way on the planet to do, seriously, on anybody's planet, to do an umbrella, all right? All right, if you can, when you're drawing something, if you will break the shape down into a clock, you will find that that is so cool. All right, here's my clock. All right, so here we go. Here's my clock. Here's my circle, right? Here's 12 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 10, 11, 1, 2. And everybody pretty much, you know it so well. I'm a little off center here with the 12. You know clocks so well that they leave the numbers off on watches because they know you know what it is. I mean, that's how... We are also brainwashed about clocks, every one of us.
What about the kids nowadays? They have to have digital, or they don't know what time it is.
Well, I know. In fact, I have some thoughts on that. So if you thought about the 12 o'clock, right, as the top of the umbrella, okay? Now, all you have to do is a little bit between 9 and 10 and 2 and 3. If you just drew a line across here like that, okay? Now, all right, just hang in there with me. And then you erase this. Now imagine that the pole came straight under here. So here's your pole for your umbrella. Now, look, can you come up here and do a little bit of a curve here like that? Just a little slight curve. And you've got an umbrella, right? And then everything comes off. See, we can curve this way off of here like that. See? Umbrella. I mean, it couldn't be easier, right? I mean, that's just... I love my umbrella demonstration. I teach this at painting parties, and people that are three sheets to the wind get this. So I know you're going to get this easily. I'm telling you what, everybody gets this. So this will be fun. We got our umbrella, put our clock, we'll put our example down. So now what we're going to do is we're going to come over here, and I'm just going to get that ruler out again, because if you're doing 6x8, you can kind of get it. I'm going to come down from the center about 2 inches. And put a dot here, just move this over a little bit, to 2 inches is where I'm starting my umbrella. And it is about 1.25 inches wide, like that. And it's coming, it's about half an inch from each edge, you know, which is like a little bit over a finger, right? So now all I have to do is just do a curve like this, like the top of a clock, right? Just sort of curve it like that. Oh, that's too much right there. And this is why you're using chalks, because chalk, why do you use chalk? Because chalk erases. You see, look at that, chalk erases. Here's our, I'm gonna come down like this. All right, here's the top of my umbrella. Here's my straight line. And then I'm just gonna come down here like this and make my, like my little fringe, right? Here's the top, and let's just come down here like this. And how far down do we go with that? About, I don't know, what do we do? 2 inches, I guess, like that, 2 inches. And then what you want to do here is just make sure that you've got this rounded pretty well, that you're pretty well balanced on this.
And don't be afraid to turn the drawing over, the painting.
Yeah, turn it upside down if you need to, you know, kind of balance it out, you know,
if you need to.
Make sure that you've got the, and if you have to, you can, you know, this is why you're doing chalk. All right, that's wrong.
Well, here's a great question. Ginger, how big can I do this painting?
Well, I think 16 by 20 would be real pretty on this. It's bigger. I might make the flowers bigger, maybe add a few more, but you certainly could do that, right?
At least a 16 by 20. We'll have to see what Andrew does with it.
Yeah, if you decide to make one. Yeah, that's right. So bring this down. Okay, so here's your stuff. Now, the flower pots, all right, I think we had one down here, just about 2 fingers above here. We've got kind of the flower pot. And as you remember last week, we showed you that your flower pot was a rectangle, and you just shaved off a little, some of the edge here like that, see? So there's your flower pot, okay? So that's pretty easy. And I've got one there, and then I've got to have, I'm just gonna put a dot where I need them. I don't need to draw these in. I just know I've got them. All right. Now that is it. It's hard to get simpler than that. I'm going to take one of my brand new ruby satin silver brushes. This is a 3/8 inch. I'm going to just rinse the sizing off of it because it's brand new.
Ooh, brand new brush.
I love that. And let's see, I'll put a little more white paint out because I used it all up in the background.
Are you going to bring the canvas back to us?
Or yes, I am.
Okay.
I'm going to come back here with a little bit of titanium white here. Okay, now I'm going to start up here like this. Oh, yeah. And I'm going to just come in here and I'm going to paint my umbrella white. Now, this is real easy. The reason you're painting it white is I want the umbrella red. But the easiest way to paint it red is to have it white first. All right. Now, as I come down here, I just bring this down like that. And skip a space like this. And boy, this really carries paint nicely too. I did two coats before with the other one, the other older brush. Here we go. Now, the reason we like these is you've got a knife blade or you can make it flat. And let's put a little bit of water in our dish here. And I have a big water bucket, but sometimes I want just the tiniest bit of water on my brush. That's kind of cool. And let's see, what did I do with this? And the other thing I like is a paper towel, like right under here, like that. A little bit of water, tap it off on the towel, then kind of spread this around like that. Because the thing about chalk, it's a great thing, but the bad thing about chalk is that it's like painting over sand sometimes, and it has a tendency to want to make everything drag. All right. So there's the top of this umbrella, and I'm just going to take a little water on the brush and kind of smooth that out, and then bring the brush strokes around and, you know, kind of down like that. There we go. Here's the little top of it. Okay, and let's come down a little further here now with a little bit of the fringe. Okay, so far so good. I might come out a little more. I'm going to turn, sometimes I'll just turn something sideways because it's just easier for me to paint. I'll put a little bit of water on this and just get that to smooth out. There we go.
When you first start out painting, Ginger, how long did it take you to get it down?
Well, when I first started painting with acrylics, I was 17. And they were really just new on the market. I was 17 years old. And my very first painting, actually, I was so pleased with that. I was really excited. It really came out good. I was really, really excited. I'd always done watercolor and stuff. And my mother was an oil painter, and I just didn't want to do what she did. Adopted mother. I was just not interested doing what she did, and she didn't like color. Everything she painted was brown. I was all about color. But I started using them right away and just loved them. But, you know, every painting, the first painting, I was really happy with it. But would I be happy with it today? No, because, you know, you get big, you get better. You know, that's the whole idea behind all of this. You get better. All right, so let's rinse our brush. Touch the bottom of a container when you're doing that. Let's come along here. Let's just take some brown paint. And I think I have a water mister here. Ha, look at all the stuff I have at hand. Just gonna mist all this. And this brown paint is old and it's really thick. That's all right. This burnt umber tends to be thick anyway. It really is like glue. All right, wake up, you know. And now I'm gonna come up here like this. Now, see, we'll start under here. And I'm gonna just about the width of the brush, I'm gonna make a little flower pot right here, just a little one. Not trying to make it too perfect. I'm going to come back here and do another one. Maybe over here. Almost, I'll kind of angle them in a bit. I'm just sort of putting them. Just got a lot of water in that paint. Okay, and then I know I've got something here, a little one here, and I've got one over here. Okay. There. Wait, what did I use there? Because that feels like raw umber to me. It is. No wonder. I'm going, what is that? That is not working for me.
Well, I can't wait till after Thursday, huh?
Well, raw umber is translucent. I'm going, that is some translucent paint here. Here's the burnt umber. You want to see the difference? Yeah, raw umber is translucent, which sometimes you absolutely want that.
But not in this case.
But not in this case. Okay, so now, good job, Ginger. Let's go straighten that out, flatten that out. Look at the difference. See?
I got a couple more questions for you if you have a
sure,
moment.
Sure. Well, I'm painting these little flower pots in, right?
Yeah. How long did it take you to learn mixing and composition? You know, how did you learn your colors? Was that like an overnight thing?
No, you don't learn stuff overnight. You just, you know, you just don't. But remember, acrylics dry very, very quickly. So, you know, if you're mixing a color, right? Oh, I tell you what. I found some Walter Foster books back in the day, right? My day, okay? And I used to read those back when they were a dollar. That's how, you know, I'd buy those. They're almost like giant comic books for artists, right? In those days, big paper things. And I read stuff on color mixing and stuff. And I read those books. They helped me a lot. And I bought lots of books over the years to increase my art education because I had found that. And I took some classes from some personal teachers. Mostly they were oil painting teachers because no one did acrylics. And I studied under some different artists. But I would say the main thing I got probably so much of my knowledge out of books, those old Walter Foster books, I'd read it. And I'd read books. You guys, I mean, there was no YouTube, see? So, you know, we had to find, you know, had to go to another artist. There's no internet. There's
no computers.
YouTube. No computers. It sounds like we're all whining here. No computers. There was at the back of the day, and we walked 16 miles to school. Well, I made Cinnamon bicycle to school. That's, you know, she used to have to bicycle to school. And she went to this private school, and my neighbor's kid was the same age, her granddaughter, and they went to the same school. And it was for gifted children. And she would drive her daughter to school. You know, granddaughter used to live with her to school every day, that 2 miles or 4 miles, went very far. And she said, I don't understand why you won't carpool for me. I said, well, she's riding her bicycle. It gives kind of tires her out by the time she gets there. She's ready to learn. And I just don't want to start anything. You know what I mean? And one day my neighbor said, your kid's down on Lone Jack Road throwing some sort of major temper tantrum. You might want to go look, right? And she had this old Murray bicycle. And the chain had come off, and she was sitting there just stomping up and down. She was so upset because she was just before cell phones too, right?
Oh, absolutely. I mean,
she was not 3 blocks from the house. She could have walked home, right? Gum got us, you know, because her dad and I were always home. But after that, we went out that day, and we bought her the best bicycle we could lay our little hands on. And that was fun. We did that. And, you know, her dad was one of those people that believed that you started off with something not very expensive, and if it didn't break, then you didn't buy a better one. But if it broke, then you bought the best one. But otherwise, you were okay with the least expensive. That was his tool policy. So we all went with that.
I remember that. You know, it works.
But, all right. Do you see what we just did here? And we got, some little pots. This is pretty simple, right, so far?
I love those little pots. It'd be nice with color, but...
Well, you know... One step at a time, right?
It's all about
layering.
So now
I have to dry these. It's all about layers. So now I'm going to dry these little pots. So and I'm going to dry this red umbrella. What do you think of that?
Well, it's white at the moment.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm going to dry it.
But you said a red umbrella.
Well, see, I have a red umbrella I'm looking at. I don't know what you're doing. I see a red umbrella.
We don't get to see all that.
Oh, too bad. Well,
all right. Get the dryer.
Let me hit the dryer. You show them some more stuff.
I'll do that. All right. We got her quieted down for a moment. From Christine, we have some grapes. This is her before picture, again, with the Ginger Cook Pack, what we call the Ginger Pack. This is your personal art coaching. Oh, she seemed to get louder. Personal art coaching. This is the before. Here's what Ginger sent back to her. You got nice grapes, good background. Curve the stripes. See, the bowl looks flat. Let's go back for a second. Notice how the bowl doesn't look round? All right? Because the stripes aren't rounded. Okay, so there's what Ginger sent to her. And let me find Christine. And here's the after. And wait a minute. I get the right buttons here. And What is going on with my silly? Let's see. Grapes. We want Christine's after. Should be that one. Okay. Let me turn ginger back up. Okay. But let me bounce between these two. So that's after the ginger pack, the personal art coaching recommendations. And we're going to bring back the before again so you can bounce between those two. There's the before. I mean, just look at the difference in those with a little coaching from our hero, Miss Ginger.
So cute. Am I on? You can say these things?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Nice. Yeah, I'm sorry.
All right. Okay.
And look at there. See? Quite a difference. All right. Let's see what Ginger's doing over there because she is painting again.
I dried this down, kind of getting rid of the chalk line, right?
Oh, okay.
Because it's a little confusing. I'm going to put a little bit of this gray back here because I kind of changed where I put the center of the umbrella. There. See? There, so there's my umbrella. Right?
I did mute her. I don't know why she came through loud that time. I totally agree with you. She was totally too loud.
Yeah, okay, so now we've got this umbrella and it's dry and our things, our pots are dry. So what we're going to do, where'd the picture go? Here. So now we're going to just go ahead and we're going to take Naphthol Crimson. That's our nice bright red. That's your red on the color wheel. That's your primary red. And we're going to just paint this in. Now look how this brush will do an angle like that. One of the things I notice that when people paint large objects like this umbrella red, they want to outline it. I suggest you start in the middle and then spread out. Does that make sense? Start out. Start in the middle and then spread out. I'm going to leave a little bit of a white border around the bottom of this. I could paint that in later, but already got it. So see, now what I love about this brush, and you can see, look what a new one does, is that it allows you to get such fine detail as well as a massive areas, all right? And then again, I'm going to say that the brush strokes are all coming down from the top here, like that, all coming down this way. All right, so there's the umbrella. Let me just bring this down a bit more. I'm just going to, even if I have to go back and put white, that's okay. But I'm going to bring that down a little bit more like that. Here, I'm going to lower this just a hair here. Then I'll come back with a white border. Would have been nice if I'd had it perfect, but I didn't. So that's okay. So, all right, so that's our umbrella here. Then I'll come back with a little white border later when this dries. Now, I'm going to take a little bit of zinc white right now, and I'm going to come up on the top of this just in a couple places and then wipe it off while it's still wet. Sometimes when it rains, there's a little bit of a shine to it, so I've got quite a bit of white on here, and I'm just saying that there's a bit of light here, not going all the way down. I'm going to go back this way too. Say that there's where the white's coming from the rain. Wipe the brush off. Just fuzz that out a bit. Okay. Now that's the zinc or your mixing white. That's not your titanium. All right. So there's we're indicating that there is some water up there. Then what we'll do later is maybe add a little titanium. But right now that's all we needed to do to indicate that there was some water on that umbrella. Now I'm going to rinse the brush off, and we're going to start in the back with some titanium white. Let's use some of these new brushes. Why am I just let's use all the new toys. What is this? I don't remember ordering this. I must have though. This is a number 2 bright silver ruby satin silver number 2. That's kind of cool. Let's use that. I like that. Let's put this here. Here's some white with a small little brush. Now I'm going to come up here like this. And this is my yellow flower. Can you see that? That's my yellow one. So I'm going to just tap in some white here in little dots and say that there's my yellow. Yellow only paints happily over white. You want something yellow in acrylics, make sure you've got it white first, okay? So that's nice. I'm going to say that one's there. And then let's take a little bit of yellow and a little cad red medium, and let's make a little bit of a kind of an orange color like that. That's pretty. That's a nice bright color. I'm going to wipe off the excess because I was mixing with it. Now, where can we put this? I'm going to say that I want this color right here on top of this pot, like that. See, I'm not even going to see the bottom of that pot. That's why I didn't worry too much about what it looked like. Okay, so I'm going to say there's that pot, right like that. There's that flower. Generally speaking, let's see, here's some quadricone magenta. Let's put that back over here. Just do some quadricone magenta. Tap it over here like this. Say there's this flower. And, all right. And do you can you mix it? You can't really. But you could pick a different color that you want.
What brush are you playing with right now?
This is a number 2 bright from the short handle, ruby satin silver. This is one of the new ones. Okay. All right, so I've got that one. Then I'm going to take a little bit of, we had a pot over here. Let's put these flowers in. Let's take some naphthol crimson and white. That's that color we were using for the umbrella. And let's tap in a little group of flowers right here in front of this. And see how they're all kind of touching like that, just tapping it in, kind of zooming in. Are you zooming in?
I've got, well, you're seeing it. You want me tighter?
Tighter, yeah.
You
come,
got it,
come,
boss.
Come tighter. Come tighter so you can really see what we're doing here, and I'll try to get this closer.
Here, I can go back. Don't forget your palette for a while, because you're basically using
the same colors. It's just reds, and it's fine. So we're tighter, so you can kind of see what we're doing here.
There we go.
You see how this, and then I'm going to just kind of wipe the brush off and come back over here, some dark red, and tap it in here on the bottom part here, make this a little darker, okay? Now, what else can I do while I'm still playing here? I've got a pink flower that's going to go here. So let's take another magenta, just come up here like this. I'm going to say this is a darker magenta. It's kind of coming here and around this flower pot like that. I'm just trying to see what I can do here before I have to change, right? And then I'm going to rinse the brush. And while I'm doing that, I'll just take a little bit of a cad red medium and a little bit of the burnt umber and make kind of a reddish brown color. Kind of a burnt sienna color. Actually, you know what would make a better one is purple. Did you know that purple and cad red medium make a pretty good burnt sienna? There we go. That's probably better. Let's do that. Purple. Wipe the brush off. There we go. So I want to just come down here on my flower pot. Kind of tone this one out down in the front a little bit. A little bit more cad red medium with this. It's a little brighter. There we go. Come down here on this front flower pot. How about some yellow and orange? I'm just not getting happy with the color here. Okay, like that. All right, so we're saying that there's our little bit of gold here on this front flower pot. And I'll come back here with a little brown. Just needed something. So kind of shape it up in front here. This front one I kind of care about the most because you're seeing it, okay?
How do I darken red?
How do you darken red? Ultramarine blue makes a kind of a, if you need to darken red, it would be ultramarine blue.
Just a little bit at a time.
Mm-hmm, a little bit at a time. Now, this is how much I've got this. I could take a little bit of gold back here and say that I could put a little bit of gold maybe back here. Let's see, I've got 1, 2, 3, just maybe a band around the pot like this, like that. Couple little bands on the pot, just something kind of fast. Now, I have to dry this before I do anything else, and that's my big thing. It's like this is about as far as I can get with this before I do anything else. So that's the secret for most things is you've got to dry. Otherwise, you have a hot mess. All your colors bleed in. Somebody sent me something, through an email the other day, and it was all the colors had grayed out because they hadn't dried in between, and that's real important. You got to dry stuff.
Show them
one of these we got back in the mail from one of our gals here.
Students. That's the last one I've got.
All right, so I'm gonna dry this, you guys, while we're waiting.
All right, I've turned her down. I've turned her down. Still sounds pretty loud to me. Anyways, here we go. This is a flower pot. We have some cimarron. I like how that's looking. Look at the green in the back on that. the tree on the left. I really like how that came out. A little bit of glare, but it's really a nice looking painting. That is really the last one we've got today that we're going to share with you in the drawing. We do want to mention, though, the Ginger gift, the fan birthday gift, will be announced on Wednesday's show. It'll be up live after that. We will also be putting up some paintings for sale. Some original paintings will also be listed at the same time. And we have enough Ginger back. Ginger?
Hi. Okay.
Oh, good.
I'm back. That's, isn't that beautiful? Don't you think she did a swell job? I like the path she created in that painting. And it's, you know, just beautiful. It's not, that's just a charming painting. That's just happy, isn't it?
I think it's a happy painting.
Well, look at, what do you say when you love somebody? You give them flowers.
Absolutely.
Isn't that true?
That's what you say.
You know, and what do we say when somebody passes away? We give people flowers. Flowers are really an expression of the, you know, they're really quite wonderful. And you know, the nice thing about it, you don't have to be a gardener to have flowers. If you're an artist, you just paint them, right? Paint big pictures of flowers all over your house. You'll never miss them.
There you go.
I'm just kidding. All right, so now I've got my big brush here, this angle one that I was using. This was the 3/8 inch angle, all right? Let's put our little thing back. Now, before I get too carried away with this, I'm going to take a little bit of yellow and just right over these back yellow flowers that were white, now I'm painting them with yellow. See that? See? There we go. So those are yellow now. That's the only way that would show up. Now I'm going to take a little bit of the Naples yellow, or you could just add some white and add some highlights to that in lighter colors right here on the left, and then a little bit of yellow oxide on the right. Flowers should be two tones, sometimes three colors. So here's the darker yellow oxide, and then you've got the bright yellow. See that? So you want, make sure that you've got your two-tone colors in here, just like the old Chevys used to be two tones, you know, in the cars. Two-tone cars.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Classics.
You know, the insurance companies that I don't think want to keep paying for all those cute colors, but there used to be some great colors. All right, now I've rinsed my brush, wiped it off on here like this. Now, remember I said we might add a little bit more on the umbrella. So here's a little bit of white right up here. Ooh, too much. Right on the top here of our umbrella to indicate a little bit of light spot right up here with the rain splashing. Now I'm just going to come here like this using my knife blade. Look at this. Look at the highlight I can get on that stick. Isn't that cool? All right, now, when you're using a brush like this, flatten it out, and then you can come here, under here like this, like there you go. Harder you push, the fatter the line. Here we go. Now we're gonna say here's our, let's wet the brush, wipe it off, a little bit of water. There we go. Here's our stripe going this way. All right. There we go. All right. So there's our little umbrella. And you, if you wanted, you could suggest, you know, some folds in it like that. Okay. Now what we're going to do here is we're going to start pulling some. Take a little bit of the mixing white, or the zinc, and come down here like this. And start pulling some little bit of white streaks coming down out from under this, like this. Watch out for your yellow. And like, just like this, we're going to start suggesting rain by pulling in some little streaks, like that. This is sort of your transparent white, like that. So make some longer and some shorter. It's real important. This isn't a fence, okay? And then when you get down here, down toward the bottom, we'll work on that in a minute because we have to put some reflections. Now I'm going to come up here, as long as I'm doing it, up to the top, and I'm going to add some little bits of rain, and I'm going to add maybe some white now, titanium. Look at the difference. Here's the titanium white, and it's brighter. The titanium white is a bit brighter, so you can add a few dots here and here of titanium in a few places to indicate sort of little raindrops coming down. Like that, something just kind of falling. And then just a few little streaks like that. Just a few, you don't have to get too crazy. Okay, and as you come down here, let's just put in a few little more right like that. And maybe I'll put some next to this. Okay, like that, something like that. All right, so I don't want to do much more to this till we put in all the flowers. But I mean, you have to admit, this is pretty fun. It's not too hard, right? It's just, you just got, just don't overdo it, okay? There you go, like that. So some nice rain. And now I'm going to add some more flowers. So here's, I'm in the titanium white. Here's a little magenta, a little bit of white. Now I wanted some pink flowers right here, see? I've dried that, so I'm going to say here's some pink flowers. The dark's under the bottom, and the lighter stuff's on top. Like that. There we go. Some pink flowers. You want to, are we zoomed in pretty tight?
I can get tighter.
Okay, and then let's come over here to this one and do the same thing. Maybe not quite as bright, but let's lighten up the pink on this one. See, right over the dark magenta, like that. Okay. Now what I can do here now is just pull some pink back down in here, and maybe even a little bit of red. I'm going to just pull some red colors, kind of zigzag some colors in here like that. Okay, as long as I've got it. And I might take a little bit of that brown color, and I'm going to sticate under the pots. All right, so you guys...
Hang in there, people.
Hang in there.
It seems to be a YouTube thing again.
Okay, so here's our flower pots, and we're just making our reflection under here like that, right? There we go, like that. There's our reflection on the flower pot. So while that's drying, I'm going to take some ultramarine blue and a little bit of titanium white, okay? And I'm going to come back here, and I'm going to, right in front of my umbrella here, I'm going to tap in a blue flower back here, like that, some sort of blue one, right there. So there's a blue one. And then I might take a little bit of white. Wow, that white is thick today. What is it with all the thick paint? Okay, so then I'm going to just tap in. Here, let's just take all the paint off the brush, go right into white. The reason being is that the blue's wet, so it'll if you go right into white, it should mix right here like that. So here's the lighter blue flower on top of there. Let's do the darker blue here. A few little dots of darker blue like that. Okay, all right, so there's that little blue flower back there. And I don't think it's not much that much of a reach to do purple, so I'm going to take a little white and purple and do a little purple flower back here behind this one.
When you did you happened to be freezing when you did the reflections. Did you dilute the paint? How did you do the reflections? That's what everybody's waiting to see.
Okay, how I did the reflections was I just went ahead and zigzagged. I had a little water on my brush, so it was a little thinner. And I just kind of zigzagged it underneath there. Am I still freezing?
No, we're back to, seems to be accepting it at the moment.
Gosh, you just never know, do you? So no. Like this, just something like this and zigzagged it back, right? Then what you want to do is take some white. And you need a white right in front of the pots, though. Here's the thing. You need to separate the reflection. You got to separate it. It's real important to separate it. All right, so now I'm back here with the purple. And I'm saying that here's a purple, dark purple flower over here. And I'll just get into the purple. Let's do the darker purple first, and we'll put some light on top of it. So here's a dark purple flower. Like that, kind of tucked in here. I mean, you can layer your flowers. I mean, there's sort of a purple one. We haven't done any stuff with it. Now, here's some yellow oxide, and I'm going to go back up here. I'm going to say there's another, like some sort of yellow oxide flower. It's a little in the distance, a little bit darker. I'm going to put one there, okay? Maybe something peeking out over here, and the rest is going to be greenery. So while that's drying, and you'll notice I'm always pinching my brush every time I do this. I'm going to add some highlights to this color, which was this red. Put a few little highlights in this, maybe just even some zinc white in here. A little bit of highlights on this little red flower right here. And then what about this one? Let's take yellow, because that was sort of an orange flower and cad red medium. Let's take some brighter color, maybe just even some cad yellow medium. And tap on the top of this and say that there's our brighter flower, and then here's some cad red next to it. That's because you notice our flowers are getting several layers of color. See that? So they're sort of brightening up because they're doing a few layers of color. And then maybe right in here, we'll just tap in a little bit of yellow like that. Okay, so that's that flower. And then if I've had that, maybe I'll put a little bit of this orange right here in the, somewhere here, I'll add a little bit of this shadow color here. You know, the reflection maybe from this. Okay. I mean, that, I think that is just so cool, the way you can just kind of create this. Now, we haven't put any white on top of our purple. So here's, it's still a little bit damp, but here's a little bit of lighter highlight on top of this purple flower. Didn't want it that white, but here we go. Tap that in there, it's a little bit lighter on top. Okay, that's sort of the secret to this stuff. You've got to have the darker color kind of underneath and the lighter color on top, okay? Now, to make a green, let's just switch brushes here. To make a green, we'll just take some ultramarine blue and yellow and maybe a little bit of that Southern Ocean blue or phthalo blue and a little bit of white. And let's just make sort of a nice bright green. Let's put some more yellow with it. Okay.
What was the dark yellow you used in the back?
Yellow oxide. Or yellow ochre. That's the yellow oxide. Now, just come on up here like this and tap in a few leaves. Let's make that a little bit darker, a little more ultramarine blue into that green. Okay. There we go. So here's our, using just our little brush here, we're going to say that there's some green leaves coming out this way around these plants. Okay, that's pretty easy. Just sort of like in filler, and they're going to come back in front of this one. Say that there's some green leaves. Now, you may have to dry this first. If your stuff's still wet and you think you're going to touch it, then dry it. All right, that's what I would tell you, is that you want to dry it then. You might just dry in between layers. If you'll do that, then the green and red are complements. So you get green too close to red and you have sort of a hot mess. If it starts to touch, green and red start to touch, then everything goes dark on you and dirty. The colors get too dark and dirty for you. You're not going to like it. All right, and at this point, I'm going to dry this, John.
Okay.
I'm going to dry this.
All right, while she's drying that, I don't have anything else to show you at this time, but we do want to remind you again, the ginger fan gift will be given out on Thursday.
On Wednesday.
Oh, I've been reminded that Wednesday's her birthday, even though we've been thinking it was Thursday for months, but it is Wednesday. On Wednesday. During the show, we'll announce where it is. And with that, you'll be able to get it free for a while, be able to watch it either online or download it to your computer. So that is something that Ginger is giving to you for being such loyal fans. We hate it when we have a YouTube issue because we were up to like 270 people watching and now we're down to 200 because of a hiccup.
I love it. I'm drawing the wrong one.
And Ginger just stopped drawing because she was drawing the one that was her first one that she did. I guess she wanted to make sure it was really dry. If you've not been to the website, gingercooklive.gallery, we encourage you to do so. Right now, we're not sure for how long, but if you sign up for the 7-day membership for $9.95, you will also be able to get one of the, what we call the ginger packs, one of the paintings that you do on the lessons, ginger pack, which is the ginger personal art coaching. It will be available from one of the paintings that you're working on the 7-day plan. That's something new. That way you can check us completely out before you sign up for a lifetime membership.
Lifetime. Man, you made some commitments. That whose life are you talking about? You know,
we'll go with Sammy.
Sammy's life. Oh, okay. All right. So you see, we dried that, right? Now we're going to take a little more yellow and add it to our green. All right. Now here's our lighter green. Let's pick some titanium white to that too. Now here's some lighter green leaves, and let's see. I had that brush in water. I'm going to pinch it off. All right, so here's my lighter green leaves like that. They're coming up here like this, maybe this way. Okay, like that, and let's come over here. I want to put some back in here. And here's the trick. You want a few leaves coming out of your flowers, but you can't do that if they're wet. Okay, because it won't work. So you can have a few green leaves as long as, your flowers are dry. So you can have a few little pots come out. And then, you can have some green coming down here on the flat of the table. Now make sure your brush strokes are going sideways now, east-west, when you're coming down this way. I'm going to say that there's some green coming down here like this. And, there's really not a lot to, there's maybe some green right there. Okay, so we've suggested that. All right. Now you could go on with more umbrellas and more flowers. This is how you do this. Now let's come back with a little yellow oxide. Remember I told you yellow doesn't paint at all over white. Now, because this brush... Okay, so I had that in water, but you really got to pinch this one off. All right, so this is my second coat of yellow. Might even put some cad with this.
What brush are you using
this
again?
This is that little tiny bright number two. But just any small brush, a little zero brush would work. You just need a smaller one. All right, so I'm going to just say I'm just adding some more flower back here, that I had a little bit kind of tucking behind this greenery, right like that. And again, the sky's the limit. It's your imagination. Your flowers, but you can add a few more. But this is how you do it. Now, here's this.
You're not using any type of medium, are you?
Oh no, no mediums.
No mediums.
Medium free. Yeah, absolutely. Now, what I want to do is add some. I want to take. Let's just put this away, and I'll show you some different brushes. As long as we're playing, I got all these ones in the mail. Let's use them. Let's see what else I got. Let's see, where did this... All right, so here's the small package. These are 000 brushes, the 000. This is your real fine point. I'll open these.
I would think they're very fine detail.
Very fine detail brushes, okay? And they come with little protectors, these little plastic protectors on the ends of them. Okay, let's just get out one. I'll show you. So here's a little small one. And I'm going to just do white paint like this. And what I want to do is I want to just create some little kind of oval circles in here with the white. Kind of like this, indicating that we've got some water on the ground like this. So I'm going to put some little tiny white streaks. Could have done that with that angle brush too, by the way. Just cross over some of your highlights, from the reflection. You want to go over the reflection. You always want to cross over your reflections. And I'm going to just add a few little dots of like little water droplets here, just a few here on the ground like this. Just a few. Don't get carried away. Just a few, kind of a shorthand here. And let's just come back up here with this little one and add some tiny streaks coming off the umbrella like that. Oh, some little dots here. There we go. Here we go, like that, that highlight right there. Now we're coming, I'm just sort of looking at that. What could I do? Could I put a few little streaks coming down here like this, just a few little dots right in front, kind of like I've got there. Like that. You don't need too many, but just a couple isn't bad. Sort of lost this little flower pot here. This one here, I sort of lost it, so I'm going to put it back. I'm going to just increase the size of this flower pot a little bit. Got a little small, but this is what we like. This is why you dry everything. This is why we like acrylic painting, because you can do that. If you lost your flower pot, just put it back. That's all right. Doesn't matter.
Here's a comment.
Uh-huh.
These reflections do not have to be parallel to the ground. ? They seem parallel to me.
Well, your pots are underneath the pots, but you want them zigzagged, right? The thing of this is you want them sort of zigzagged underneath the pot like this, right? And then they're parallel this way, right? They're not going up and down anymore, right? They're going this way. Yeah, they are. So, you know, this one looks a little bit, here, let me change brushes a little bit here. This one kind of, like right here, this little one right here. You want it underneath the flower pot, right? That's the deal. They're underneath the flower pot, but there's other colors that you're kind of overlapping with this too, which means we have to dry. But let me take a little bit of magenta first, and I wanted to do a little bit of a darker part on this side of the umbrella. I didn't do that, and I want to put a little bit of magenta right there. There we go. This side of the umbrella, make that side a little bit darker. If you didn't have that, listen, let me show you. Ultramarine blue and naphthol crimson make a very nice dark color. It's not quite magenta, but it's very close. Do you see it? Isn't that pretty close? It's a little bit darker, but if you needed some dark somewhere to just sort of balance your picture, you didn't have magenta, you know, for a shadow color, ultramarine blue works pretty well. And you could say that the bottom of this awning was a little darker too. Or maybe you just go pure cad red again and just do another little layer like that. Okay, like that. There you go. So you can say that that's getting kind of darker, right? Now I'm rinsing. And there isn't, and this one, if I just, let's see, let me just get this one out of the way. Let's put these side by side now so that I can sort of even them out. I've lost my paper here, so. Here we go. Let's just sort of even these out. Get this out of the way. All right. So you can kind of see what I've got, right? All right. So they're very, you know, we got very, very similar. We could have, what do we have here that we don't have up there? We could have a little bit more of the light, maybe some light green coming down this way. Maybe a little bit of light green coming in here in a reflection like that. Like this. Just very little. You can overdo this really quickly. Break that up a bit, okay? And then the other thing I'd probably do is maybe just have a little bit more of the lighter red here. Let's just take a little bit of the, I want a little bit lighter color right here on the top of the umbrella, right like that. There we go. There, kind of just sort of even that out a little bit. And I think I want another little green separation between here and here. Put that there between those two colors. Could you add some more? I mean, could you put another color back even behind here? You could. For instance, it would be simple enough. For instance, right back here, and it's so easy when you're doing this, add another little flower back behind the other side of the umbrella, you know, on the back side of the umbrella, right? Like over here, you could have another little, you could indicate that simply by putting the stem in front. Like that, just put the stem back in front, or the pole, there you go. So you can have another little plant kind of on the other side of that. I didn't do it in this one, but you certainly could, like that, and just tap in using the corner. What I like about these brushes is you can use the corner, and then that gets you just exactly, yeah, let's put the stem back, that pole back. Okay, so that's kind of fun. And then I'm saying, where else do I want some of this mixing white? And I think I want some underneath here and pulling this down, sort of this translucent color, like that. Let's just pull some more, just pull some down a little bit. Let's just exaggerate this, like that, see? And maybe exaggerate this right here, a little bit of light. Right next to here, this pot. A little bit of right next to this pot. Let's put a few little light streaks in here like this. Down here at the bottom. And something back here. Kind of zigzag around. Could still do a little bit of like a pink color like this. As As long as that green's dried. If the green hasn't dried, stay away from the pink. Okay? Or the reds. If you've got to make sure that your greens are dry before you do this. But you can add a little more color in here like this to the front of your for your reflections. And let's see, what else were we going to do here? I kind of like this green going all the way off. This light green going out this way. Well, I kind of like this doing this. Maybe a little darker, a little phthalo. Let's make a darker green here. There we go. Darken up a few little of these greens on this side. Okay, and I'd say that's kind of how you... That's how you paint this, which I think is kind of cool, actually. And it just, you notice I always keep pinching my brush. I might just come up like this and straighten that one up like that. That's our picture, John. Isn't that cool?
I think it's another marvelous job.
Just
another award winner, as it were.
Oh, well, I think it's sort of fun to do. And if your white gets contaminated, don't keep playing in it. Here, I still feel like I want a few little white drops right here like this. Right on this umbrella, like that. Just a couple. There we go. Just bring this down. There we go, like that. Just down from the top. And for sure down here. And let's see, where's my... You want to keep your gray color. If you didn't make it... I always tell people to keep their background color, a little of their background color. Yes, you can remix it if you don't have it. You can remix it, but it's nice if you can keep it, because sometimes it's nice to come back and add a little shadow color, come back under here and just maybe separate out something like that. You can just put a little shadow if you need something darker. If you need to, here's an example, if you need to darken, say, maybe this side of your canvas on this side, just darken something. You can do that, kind of pull your eye in, darken something. So try to save a little of your background color. That's never a terrible idea. Also, if you have to make a few little awning repairs, you can come under it like this, you know, and slim up an awning if you had to do that, something like that. So there we go, you guys. I'm liking this. Hope you are too. This was fun. I can answer a few questions while I'm sort of finishing up.
I think we've been staying on top of them. But let me scroll back up and see. Scrolling, looking. Now, we do want to mention that the ginger gift, the fan birthday gift, will be available on the website, is where you'll have to go to get it. We will announce it on YouTube, and we'll have probably a little speed painting advertisement for it to give the link and everything. So that's how you'll find
that. But the thing about it is, what's so unique about it is that you can actually, you don't have to download it, but it's yours. You can save it to your computer. It's your gift. It's your video lesson. It, you know, belongs to you. Now,
and it's
just
a little over an hour long, but yeah. It's a classic. And it has a great story in it. We know how you love the story.
Oh, yeah. The drama. There's the great birthday saga.
The birthday saga.
The birthday sagas of...
yours truly.
I debated whether even to tell the story, because it's kind of, you know.
It's one of those mixed bags.
It's a mixed bag, but it's true. And it's the birthday saga, and it's kind of, yeah. It's definitely the soap opera part, okay? I think you'll like it. It's the soap opera part of the birthday saga, which is sort of fun, right?
Somebody asked a question, why the gold blobs in the back, I still don't get them. That was a while ago, so I'm not sure if they get them now or not.
Well, they're flowers, hon. They're flowers. They're background gold flowers, you know?
Yeah, so I'm not sure what to get or not get on that one. Sorry.
Yeah, they're gold flowers, and you can add a few little high... You know, you start with the darker colors, right? And then if you want to, you can add...
You just keep building it up?
You just start building up your flowers. They wouldn't have to be gold. They could be something else, right?
What is Ginger doing for her birthday?
Teaching you guys something. We have
working.
A house guest. We're taking I'm meeting Cinnamon for breakfast, and in the morning. Okay, Actually, I like this nice big flower back here better than this one. See, I made this one a little bigger. Kind of like it, don't you?
Yeah.
Like it. Then put a little.
I like the yellow one.
This
the yellow
here.
On the left on the other one better.
This
it just
one?
Seems like you're too strong on the one. That one, right? Yeah. Point your.
Oh, this one. Oh, you're saying that this one because it's brighter?
Well, it's too bright.
What? Who asked you?
Sammy told me to tell you because he doesn't want to get yelled at.
Well, listen, the peanut gallery can just cut it out here, you know?
Hey, you asked for opinions.
Not yours.
Oh, sorry. Silly me to think that you'd want my opinion. What came over me?
Just focus on the cameras, you.
I totally went out of turn this time, didn't I?
My gosh.
We'll have to see what... Sammy, do you have an opinion on this at all there, Bear Buddy? You got your buddies back at all? Somehow I doubt it. Probably still going to be in trouble for this one.
I guess so. You know, acrylics dry darker. This is the thing you got to appreciate. So you'll notice I'm going over here, even as we're done, adding a few pink highlights.
Well, see, you fixed it. That's all I wanted. A couple of blobs, of it, just like that, to break it up.
And the same thing, yeah. Well, you
see,
know,
you did
nice
it.
To want things, John.
Well, I wanted it, and I won that one.
No,
I'm
didn't.
A winner.
You didn't win nothing. You've won air here, babe.
No, I won. I'm going to win the prize. I get the free download on Wednesday. I'm all excited.
Okay. All right. That's
it's
good,
all mine.
Right?
Mine.
You know what? Okay. I like it. I like it a lot. Here, let me just turn.
That's
this
all
up
the questions
here.
I can get to. The rest have scrolled off because they were a chatty group tonight.
We had a chatty group tonight. Well, it was just fun, and you know that's the fun. You guys, and those of you who are watching this later, right? If you are not taking advantage of these live course classes that we do, the half the fun is chatting with all the fun people that you're going to see online.
Who are you going to bump into?
Great fun. You're going to bump into people, and you get to know people, and you're going to have these online friends. That you may never meet in person. It's better than a pen pal. They'll tell you. It's fun, isn't it?
And you get people all over the world. Australia, it's 109 degrees today.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's what I said. But Sue said, send me the heat. She's tired of the cold. See, you just can't be
well,
happy.
Carolyn Banks is another one of our friends from Australia. Hi, Carolyn Banks. So she's another one. You know, so we got people in Australia.
We got Canada.
We have Canada. A lot of Canadian friends.
We've kind of lost our European group. At this time,
we haven't lost anybody.
Well, they don't show up very often anymore.
Oh, live classes?
Yeah.
Well, that's 2 a.m. for them.
And we care. We do.
We do.
Occasionally, we're going to have surprise classes.
Yeah, for them because you know it's a lot. You know, Mona hangs in there. We got the Netherlands.
The white,
you know, the most guys.
White Wolf.
They're
white
hanging
fox,
it. You know, she. They hang in there with us. You know, but. And occasionally we see Gianova, but you know what? It's late in the morning, and it's really not fair to ask people to stay up till 2 a.m. But it is fun, because everybody, here's the thing about you guys that are around the world. For those of us that are in the States, we're all just so, I'm sorry, we're all just sort of thrilled that you're hanging out with us at this time. It's great fun, right?
Yeah.
And we're really glad that you're doing it. You know, I'm going to tell you, we're really glad. Let me just cut some of this red.
I love it when you
bit.
Say you're done and work for another half hour.
Well, I'm just looking at
it. But it's looking so much better each time you do it.
Well, you know, you just do a few little things,
yeah.
And then you look and you do a few little things more. And your red's one of those wonderful colors that you can take a few coats to really show up, too. So, all right. So, I mean, I'm liking that. I'll put a little of this red down here, too.
Oh, it's cooled off in Australia. It's down to 90.
Oh, good. It gets up to 90 here in Houston.
Yes, it does.
In the summertime. I mean, it can get really hot here. And I went to school in Arizona, and we used to call it the surface of the sun. You
it
know,
gets
that
warm.
Was so hot. It got,
but it's
it
a dry
warm.
Heat.
Oh, you know, that's just such BS, this dry heat stuff. You know what I mean? When it's 110, it's 110. You know what I mean?
Any way
you're
you
not
look
dry
at it,
anymore.
It's hot.
So you're sweating. You're not dry anymore. So there you go.
Hey, somebody noticed Sammy's space suit. Thank you.
Thank
he
you.
Loves it.
That was a gift from Cinnamon and her family.
Yep.
For Sammy for Christmas. Which we thought was kind of cool. Now you see here, I'm just, I don't want to lose all my reflections here. Here's a little bit of brown here. I'm going to come back and add a little more reflection here like that. Acrylics are so forgiving. You can just come back and, You could fool around with them a little bit, see? You could just have fun with them. All right, that's our picture. I think this was a fun thing to do. I'm really enjoying my brushes. Those little sharp ones, those little tiny ones, these little tiny, tiny ones are great. These little 000 ones are really great for signing your name. And here's the deal, you guys.
Do I need to zoom out? You can do something on the palette?
I'm going to take some, some white paint here, which I'm out of. Sign my name. What I was going to tell you was, I could have done white or I could have done blue. I think last time I did blue. Maybe I'll do blue. The thing of it is that when you're doing that, roll your brush. Mist your paint. That's the other thing, too. Mist your paint. Mist your fell on the ground. When you're trying to do something liquidy, either buy some more of the flow kind of paints like the, or mist your paint, then roll it off the brush like that. So you just roll it off so that when you go to paint it, and notice where I'm holding my, zoom in on this, notice where I'm holding the brush, right like this. See where I'm holding the brush? Now I'm going to just come up here like this. And I probably will get paint for each letter. Maybe I can get two, no, not really. And if I think you'll be less frustrated if you do it that way, and then we'll put the little red slash through, which is a thing we'll tell you about another time.
Go watch one of the other videos that has it on it.
Mm-hmm. And then
you
Now I'm going to come back under here because I lost my white. See, under this pot. Here. So good memory. There you go. There. See. So now that's sort of. This is the titanium now. Before, remember we were doing the.
Mixing white,
so it wasn't as bright. So now here we're doing the titanium. A few little bits of the titanium streaks in here too. So it's not all titanium. Kind of break that up. And there's our umbrella in the, flowers in the rain. You guys,
flowers in the rain. We have a title for it. Can anybody remember that? Hopefully.
Some of us can remember that. And did I get all the chalk off of here on that edge?
You're going to have to wait till tomorrow when it dries.
When it dries. You guys know about that, right? You just,
you take a
clean brush, if you have chalk, and just come right on up to it like this.
Oh, you still had a little bit there, didn't you?
Yeah, I had a little bit. I could just see it. See? And you can erase it like that. You should wait till it's dry, but there you go. There. All right.
So do as I say, not as I do.
Well, I was careful.
Of course.
I was careful.
You were absolutely careful. You were perfect.
Here, I know, I was careful. I just want to do this. There, see, I needed to do that. Now, don't ask me why, but I did.
Oh, they want an encore performance. They can't sleep. They want another story and another painting.
Another painting. Nobody's sleeping. We got you up at 3 a.m. Now you want something else to...
Now to keep going here.
Let's put a little of this mixing white right here. The top of it. I don't know why. I was studying what happens to... umbrellas when it's wet, and they get sort of shiny where the rain hits them. There we go, like that. Yeah, perfect. Okay. So, yeah, that's fun.
Now are we done?
No.
I knew.
We're almost done.
We are so close to being done, folks.
There. I just had to fix that flower. Just was bugging
me. Any closer, we'd be there.
You're so fun. Any closer, we'd be there. Yeah, I think so. So, another story. Well, we'll do more stories. It's sort of the family saga here, the family saga of
which camera are you looking at? Where are you looking? You were looking at me again, weren't you?
Yeah, because you're in the room. You're in the room, and I'm nothing. There's just.
But
this
see, when you look
at
the camera,
here.
You're looking at me because I'm looking at you and my monitor.
Well.
See, that's how
tricky.
It works.
That's tricky. You'd think after a few of these shows we'd catch on, wouldn't you? You'd
say, no.
How long does it take her to catch on?
Times we will be on time. We were real close today, though.
We were really close today. I'm telling you what. I mean, I just thought about this painting at breakfast. I think I did pretty good, don't you? I came up with this morning at breakfast. I know what I'm going to paint. I'm going to paint an umbrella in the rain. That's what I'm going to paint.
And she did it.
And we did it. With flowers. Little flower pot. And this would be a cute greeting. Someone said this would be a cute greeting card, and I thought so, too. I thought it'd be a real cute greeting card.
It'd be a great greeting card.
All right, this is great fun, you guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow night. Oh,
Oh, wait a minute.
Guess what we're doing tomorrow night? Should we show them?
Do you have it over there?
No.
Do I have it over here?
No. Well, then you guess.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Just...
No. I do. I know exactly where it is.
Well, no, that is not the same as having it right over here.
It is so close, though. I mean, for us, it's in the same room. This one, right?
Yeah, but where's the rest of it? Where's the picture? Photograph.
Okay.
I want the photo, too. You know, we get questions like this in the mail. These are inspired by you guys. Some of this stuff is inspired by you. We get questions, right? Somebody sent me this photo.
Now, again, we have you on the main camera.
All right, main camera. So back down here, right?
You put it down.
All right, somebody sent me this photo.
Hold on one second.
You ready for this?
I got to get my ears on.
Well, your ears are attached to your head.
I got to get the camera. Okay.
All right, so somebody, let me just get this picture.
You got to send you that purple paper.
There. Now, zoom back out.
I am.
Somebody sent me, said, can you show us how to paint this? Right? Bubbles. You know, wonderful bubbles.
We want to know how to paint bubbles.
Bubbles. And so tomorrow night, we're going to be painting bubbles.
Whoa! You did it.
So I'm going to, yes, I can show you how to paint bubbles. Tomorrow night, we're going to learn how to paint bubbles. Does that sound fun?
I couldn't believe she did it.
So there you go.
It came in, we printed it out, and said, yeah, let's see you do this. You think you're so good.
So anyway.
And she did.
So anyway, that's we're painting bubbles tomorrow night. Does that sound fun? I hope it is, because that's what we're doing.
I guess if you don't want to watch it.
You know, just here's our flower. Let's see, that's not where's the other one?
Get the right one. That's
yeah.
it.
This is the one. Here's our flowers in the rain, you guys.
Zooming
Enjoy
back
this.
In.
Zoom in on that, John, for the end of it. And thanks so much for watching, you guys. This was fun. And we'll see you tomorrow.
Good night, everyone. There's another exciting episode of Cookie Crumbs from Ginger Cook, Mondays, 7:30 p.m. Central. Good night, everyone.
Night.
Good night, Sammy.
Night, Sammy.
Good night, John.
Already killed us.